Although time perception is often considered a fixed and objective measure, it is fundamentally subjective and is affected by a variety of factors. This subjective nature of time perception has been likened to an accordion, expanding and contracting depending on emotions, environmental stimuli, and attentional shifts. Experimental observations show that our emotional state and stimulus characteristics can alter our perception of time. For example, anger, spiders, and the color red are perceived to last longer than neutral expressions, butterflies, and the color blue, respectively. These differences highlight the psychological complexities of time perception, an area ripe for scientific investigation. Recent research published in Nature Neuroscience by a team from the Weizmann Institute of Science offers new insights into the mechanisms underlying our temporal experiences. It provides evidence linking time perception to the brain's reward learning systems, suggesting that our perception of time is intimately linked to our predictive processes. Harvard University cognitive neuroscientist Sam Gershman has articulated a detailed understanding of the adage that time flies when you're having fun, suggesting that time speeds up not just when you're having fun, but also when the level of enjoyment exceeds expectations. This concept places the brain's reward prediction mechanisms in the context of temporal perception. The brain's perception of time is multifaceted and involves a variety of neural circuits and mechanisms that adapt to context. At the heart of this process is the neurotransmitter dopamine, which is crucial to both time perception and reward learning. Dopamine's role in temporal prediction is complex and context-dependent. It can speed up the internal clock, causing the passing of time to be perceived as fast or compress events so that they appear shorter. These effects highlight dopamine's critical role in our temporal experience. Dopamine has a well-established connection to time perception and reward learning. Dopamine-driven reward learning, unexpected rewards that lead to dopamine surges and reinforce future behavior, involves prediction errors. They developed a reinforcement learning model that can predict individual performance on a timing task, further solidifying the link between prediction errors and time perception. Neuroimaging data identified the putamen, a brain region associated with motor learning and other functions, as a critical area involved in this effect. While the precise mechanisms, particularly the role of dopamine, require further elucidation, the study has important implications for models of learning and time perception. Historically, reinforcement learning models, such as those inspired by Pavlov's classical conditioning experiments, have included the timing of rewards as an objective variable. Pavlov's dogs learned not only to associate a bell with food, but also to predict the proximity of food. The work by Torin, Aberg, and Paz brings these subjective aspects to the forefront, suggesting that the temporal dimension is integral to understanding how prediction errors affect learning. The observed biases in time perception driven by prediction errors highlight the importance of integrating subjective temporal experiences into reinforcement learning frameworks. This integration could improve our understanding of both cognitive processes and the neurobiological basis of time perception. This interaction between time perception and reward learning mechanisms opens up new avenues for research by highlighting the need to consider subjective temporal experiences in models of learning and cognition. As the field progresses, elucidating the precise neural mechanisms involved will be crucial to fully understanding how our brains process and perceive time. Research into our perception of time continues to reveal its complex and multifaceted nature. A recent discussion in the Journal of Neuroscience by researchers Masamichi Hayashi and Richard Ivry provides compelling evidence that neural fatigue also plays a major role in how we perceive the duration of stimuli. This finding, along with insights from other studies, suggests that subjective time experiences should be integrated into models of cognitive processes, particularly reinforcement learning. People have been shown to stretch or contract their temporal experience in response to various signals, which can change their perception of the temporal distances between actions and outcomes. This adjustment in perception can affect the speed at which associations are learned and highlights the need for reinforcement learning models to account for such temporal biases to accurately reflect cognitive processes. They acknowledge that future models will need to consider the interaction between prediction errors and time perception. Hayashi and Ivory's work adds another layer to this understanding. Their experiments showed that participants who were repeatedly exposed to short stimuli tended to overestimate the duration of slightly longer intervals. This phenomenon, which has been attributed to neural fatigue, occurs when neurons that respond to shorter durations become fatigued, allowing neurons tuned to longer durations to exert greater influence on subsequent perceptions. Conversely, exposure to longer stimuli led participants to underestimate shorter durations. This neural fatigue mechanism suggests that context can be manipulated to alter time perception. This finding is supported by the fact that brain scans have identified the right parietal lobe responsible for these temporal distortions. Although the right parietal lobe's role in time perception is different from the putamen studied by the Weizmann researchers, it is still functionally and anatomically connected to the putamen. These connections point to a larger, more coherent neural network that supports our perception of time. Despite the different neural substructures and mechanisms identified in these studies, the bidirectional effects on time perception observed by both Hayashi and Ivory and the Weizmann scientists point to the distributed nature of timekeeping processes in the brain. This distribution highlights the complexity of temporal perception and suggests that multiple brain regions and mechanisms interact to produce a unified experience of time. The challenge now is to identify the broad rules and computations that facilitate these interactions. Until these mechanisms are fully understood, scientists can only guess at the complex dance of neural processes that shape our perception of time. This ongoing research not only deepens our understanding of cognitive functions, but also increases the accuracy and applicability of models in neuroscience, particularly those related to reinforcement learning and temporal processing. Thanks for listening. Stay well.